learn about a combine-based project architecture that lets you place AR entities from a SwiftUI view. Hey Code Crew, this is Flo. In the last lesson, you learned about the foundations of configurations, anchors, and entities, which were needed to tell ARKit where you want to place which kind of 3D object. In this lesson, I will tell you about a combine-based architecture that I've started using myself, just to make it easy to tell ARKit what to do in a SwiftUI-based app. For that, we will use the combine framework, as I already told you. We will set up an Enum for all of our different AR actions. We will create an ARManager class that is super, super simple, so don't worry too much about it. I will tell you a bit about how combine works itself, and then we will make sure that everything works together. So to get started, I'm gonna press Command N and create a new Swift file called ARAction. Now this file only contains a single enum, which is used for all of the different actions that we want to take. So for example, to place a 3D object or to remove a 3D object, maybe to change something about the scene, whatever it may be. Every single thing that we want to be able to do in our AR scene will have its own case in this enum. So let's get started by changing the import to SwiftUI, as we will need that in just a second. And then I will create an enum called ARAction. For the sake of this video, we will implement two different actions. The first one is place a block with a certain color, and this is why we needed the SwiftUI import, because we will use the SwiftUI color. And the second case will be remove all anchors. So these are the two actions that we will implement in this video, and then you can expand on this as much as you'd like. Next up, let me move that AR action into our feature targets group in the navigator here, and then let's also create another new file that is called ARManager. Now, you don't necessarily need this file exactly. You can also store all of these variables somewhere else. I just think, as a separation of concerns aspect, it's best to have an AR manager, and you will understand what it will do in just a second. So let's change this import to combine, because we will actually need that now. So first of all, let's create a class called AR manager. We only ever want there to be one AR manager in our entire app, so we will use the singleton pattern. The singleton pattern means that there is only one instance of an object or of a class or a struct. So we will say it's a static let shared, so we can then say ARManager.shared to access the singleton. And this is just an instance of ARManager. Now this by itself is not really a singleton, because yeah, a programmer could still just create another AR manager like this. So to prevent that from happening, we will make the init private. And now only AR manager itself can call the initializer. Pretty nifty little pattern here. Okay. Before we get more into the AR manager, let me tell you about its purpose and how combine works itself. So the purpose of AR manager is to forward all of the actions from a SwiftUI view to our custom AR view. There is no super easy direct way to do this, and that's why we are adding this AR manager here. There are probably tons of different options that you could take. You could go for the delegate pattern, as you probably know it from UIKit. What I will show you here is using combine streams. Combine is a framework that's built into Xcode and that's available to every single developer, I think, as of iOS 13 actually. And Combine allows you to send data from one part of your app to another part of your app. Basically, you can also use it for other things, but that's the aspect that we will use. And if you've ever written a view model in SwiftUI and used the @published property wrapper, you have even used Combine already without even knowing about it, because the @published property wrapper is a so-called Combine publisher. There is a ton more to learn about Combine, about publishers and subscribers. And I encourage you to look into Combine, but in this video, I will just show you what we use and explain why we use it and how it works. So maybe real quick before we continue, I already told you that there are publishers and subscribers in Combine, and these are two very important concepts. A publisher sends a value and a subscriber receives a value. Super simple. So in our case, you could say the SwiftUI view sends a value, for example, place block. And then our custom AR view receives that value and then actually places a block in our AR view. So enough chit chat and enough theory. Let's continue implementing this. So in order to build this, we will create a variable and I will call it action stream. And this will be of type pass through subject. That's a super simple combined publisher that just takes a value and passes it through its stream, and then someone else can subscribe to it and use that value. So let's create that pass through subject. In combine, all of these publishers always have two generic types. One type is the actual value that you want to pass through. So in our case, an AR action. And then the other type is what kind of error could be thrown in this pipeline. So we will use the AR action as our primary type. And for the error, we will actually use a special type called never. This tells combine that this operation can never fail and the sender or the subscriber will always receive an AR action, which is the enum that we just created a second ago. Okay, so that's already all of the architectural setup that we needed. We now have our AR action enum with our two actions that we want to implement, placing a block and removing all anchors. And then we also created our AR manager, which just holds this combined pipeline so we can pass values from our view to our AR view. So let's continue in our content view, in our SwiftUI land, as I called it in one of the earlier lessons, and let's introduce some colors as a state variable. So I'm using an Xcode shortcut here, but you can also just type out @state, private var. Private is not even needed, but it's just a good practice. I will call this variable colors, and it will be an array of type color. And this will basically just be a picker where the user can select which color the block should have that they want to place down. So let's make this an array and let's fill it with some colors. So let's say green, let's say red, and let's also say blue. That should be good for now. So now we have three different colors that the user can choose from. How can they choose from it? Let's look into that next. Right now, our content view body is just our AR view, basically. I mean, we have our representable here, and then we also have our custom AR view, but really that's just an AR view, okay? Now we want to add some buttons here, so I'll just create an overlay. And I will give this an alignment of bottom, so the buttons are nicely at the bottom of the screen where the user's thumb is located, so they can easily tap the buttons. And then right now we only have three different colors, so that's not really needed what I'm going to do next, but if you want to expand on this in the future, I will just add a scroll view here that scrolls on the horizontal axis. In here, I'll also add an H stack. Okay. And now we want one button to send the remove all anchors action, and we want one button to place a block of a certain color for each of these colors. So let's start with the remove action. So let's create a button. We will fill out the action in a second. For the label, I will just use a SF symbol called trash. We will make the image resizable so we can scale it up and down, and I will also make it scale to fit so it keeps its own aspect ratio and doesn't get stretched out. Then I'll also make sure that this has a fixed frame of 40 by 40 points. Let's also add some padding, and let's also add a background with a regular material so we have a nice blur effect that always looks nice in AR apps. Okay, so this is already our trash button. Next, let's fill in the action. This is also super simple because we have our nice combined setup. So we will now access our action stream here and send a value through that, or actually an action through that. To do it, let's grab our ARManager.share, so our singleton instance. In here, let's grab our action stream, and then we can just say send a value. In this case, since our AR action is an enum, we can just press dot and have autocomplete for all of the different options. This is the remove all anchors button, so we will send the remove all anchors action. Super simple. Next up, let's copy this button, and we will need that in just a second. Now we will create a for each. over all of the colors that we have in our state variable up here. Color is not identifiable by default, so we will need to provide self as an ID, and then we can grab the color in. And now let's paste the button that we just copied. And instead of our image here that's scaled to fit, we can just use the color that we got from our for each, since color can be used as a SwiftUI view by itself. And by itself, this will actually just be a square or a rectangle. And I also forgot to add a corner radius here. So let's add a 16-point corner radius. And let's also copy that down to our color. And then, of course, instead of sending the remove all anchors action, we of course want to send the place block action with our color that we got here. Okay, now our UI should already look pretty good, or at least okay. I will actually also add some more padding to the edge stack so it looks a bit nicer. We will have a look at how the app actually looks and works at the end of this lesson. Next up, let's go into our custom AR view where things get actually very interesting. So first, let me collapse all of these examples that we added in the last lesson, and I will keep the place blue block function open because we will need that in a second. Since we are now using combine, we of course also need to import it. So let's say import combine up here. And then let's create a function to subscribe to our action stream. So let's call it subscribe to action stream. In this function, we will once again grab the action stream, so our ARManager.shared.actionStream. And with combine stuff, you often have multiple arguments chained to each other or multiple functions. So I like to do each in their own row. So right now we're not doing anything. We're just grabbing the action stream. But what we want to do is subscribe to it so we can receive the values that get passed through it. In our case, that means that our custom AR view gets informed whenever our content view sends an AR action. So for that, we can just use the sync call here. We will receive an AR action in here, and then we can add code to handle these actions in just a second. There is one very important concept in combine, and that is to keep a strong reference to all of your subscriptions. Now, I won't go into detail why this is needed, but just keep in mind that you always need to store your sync calls or your subscriptions in a certain variable. Now, in our case, I will create a private var. I always call it cancelables because that's the type that it will hold. And this will be a set of the type anyCancelable. And in the beginning, this will be empty. Now, this is just a little code snippet that you will need every single time that you use combine in your app. And then down here in our store function, we will just say store in our cancelable set. This will make sure that the subscription is kept alive even when the function is done, basically. Okay. So next up, we have our action here. Now let's write some code to actually handle these actions. So let's write a switch statement on the action. And if you remember, we should have two cases, one to place block and one to remove all anchors. So let's first implement the place block function or the place block action. Let's also grab the color in here. And then let's also implement the remove all anchors function. Okay. To place blocks, we will change up our place blue block function a bit. Let's remove that blue part from the name because we will make it more generic so we can place a block of any color really. And then we will just pass in the color as a parameter, just like this. And then if you notice, we created our material in the last lesson and we passed it a UI color. But in the parameter, we actually get a SwiftUI color. So we will need to create a UI color right here from our SwiftUI color. Super simple stuff. Okay, now that place block function is already done, and now we can call it in our subscription up here. So we can say place block of color, the color that we just got in here. Now there's one more important concept. Since this is a closure that can be executed at any time really, we will have to make sure that we don't create a retain cycle. I won't go into detail about that, but that's what leads to memory leaks and ultimately to your app crashing or slowing down the user's phone. So instead what we will do is just capture a weak instance of self. And then we can say self optionally dot place block. Now let's also quickly implement the remove all anchors functions. As I said, these are just examples. You probably will do something very different in your own apps. Just examples to show you what's possible. So in here we will say self.scene. Remember, we have this property because our custom AR view inherits from AR view, from ARKit. And then this scene has an anchors property, and we will just say remove all anchors. Okay, now our subscribe to action stream function is done. Next up, we need to, of course, call this function. So we'll just put that in our initializer. Place blue block is not there anymore, so we'll get rid of that and instead call subscribe to action stream. Okay, so now we have implemented everything that's needed to send an action from a SwiftUI view to our AR view. Let's quickly go over everything that we've done so you have a better understanding. First, we modeled all of the actions that we want to have. We called this enum AR action and it got two cases, either to place a block of a certain color or to remove all anchors from the scene. These are just examples that we chose. Next, we created an AR manager, which is a singleton. So there's only a single shared instance and nobody can create another instance. And then in this AR manager, we have our action stream, which uses the pass through subject of combine to handle AR actions that are sent from our SwiftUI view to our custom AR view. Next, in our SwiftUI view, we added a few buttons, one to remove all anchors from the scene and one button for each of our colors that we added to place a block of that color in the scene. And then lastly, we have our custom AR view, and in here we created the cancelables variable. And we created the subscribe to action stream function, which takes our AR manager.shared.actionStream. And whenever a new value is sent to that stream, this closure here will run. And if that action is place block, we will call our place block function with that color. And if the action is remove all anchors, we will take our scene, its anchors, and remove all of them. In this lesson, you learn to use combine together with ARKit and SwiftUI. You learned how to let SwiftUI views tell ARKit what to do and at which time.